So this video is talking about the governor, Gregory Abbott, and his new rescinding of a bill for water breaks for construction workers. And so basically what I've been reading, and there's multiple articles out there, the construction workers in Texas, and I guess any workers that are working out in the elements of the extreme heat, there's heat waves that are going on in Texas. And so there's this, I guess, law that protects the workers so that they could get a 10-minute water break. And Gregory Abbott, he's the governor of Texas, and he's looking to rescind that bill, basically take away the water breaks. And a number of people have chimed in, and they said it's cruel, it's inhumane. I personally believe that it is inhumane if people are working in intense, high labor jobs where they're out in a sweltering heat, and they could have heat stroke, heat exhaustion, they could die. And I'm seeing a lot of things happening when it comes to these governors in an election year. You know, they're all trying to get elected. They're all trying to, you know, reserve their seats, and they're doing a great job, but doing a lot of not great things that will affect hundreds, thousands of people, maybe more, if these laws are rescinded that protect the workers. And so I've seen multiple articles that talk about, this is one article, but it says Texas governor, he signs a bill rescinding water breaks as deadly heat grips the state. And so that's coming out of the Guardian. And so I was looking at it, and I was like, I wasn't surprised, but I was saddened, because it's just another effort or move upon these politicians who are Republicans to make life a lot more complicated and difficult for those who don't have a lot of voice and power in this situation. And we're just kind of like here and doing the work, and you know, what they say is the final decision, and it isn't always the best decision. And from what I was reading earlier, and I will read it, it looks like people have already succumbed to the heat, the extreme heat in Texas. They had people that have died just because they are over their, I would say, I'm going to add that I feel like they're probably overworked, more than likely. They're underpaid for the type of work that they do. And now you're saying that they can't get, you know, water breaks. I don't think that is fair at all. And it's inhumane. It's beyond not being fair. It's being cruel to do this. And so this is Gregory Abbott. He's the governor of Texas. So Texas governor, he signs a bill rescinding water breaks. Deadly heat grips the state. Measure will nullify local ordinances that provide workers protection from the devastating triple-digit temperatures. And I'm hearing the last one was 100, and then the one that they're looking at, it could get as high as 110 degrees, maybe more, in that type of heat that these construction workers are working in. So amid a dangerous heat wave that has brought blistering temperatures across the Texas state, the state's governor, he signed a law this week eliminating local rules requiring water breaks for workers. So the measure, which will take effect later this year, will nullify ordinances that are enacted by Austin and Dallas that mandate 10-minute water breaks for construction workers every 4 hours. So it also prevents any local governments from passing similar worker protections. So basically, they're trying to take away protections for workers. And it starts with little things like water breaks like this. So when people don't say anything and don't do anything and they get away with it, it's going to get worse. It doesn't get better. Then next thing you know, they might even go so far to take away lunch or shorten the lunch. Or maybe you don't need a lunch. Just work. Go home and eat after you finish work. I wouldn't be surprised if they get to that point. You know, because it always happens in little steps where they start, like the book banning, that's happening. They want to take things out of the schools, or they want to stop people from learning about other people's situations or learning about who other people are really in the world. And they think that they're using kids as a pawn to say that we're hiding the information from kids because we think they're too young to understand, although their friends' parents are gay. What do you do with that? I mean, you know, kids are going to school and they have gay parents, so how are you going to hide that kind of information? The kids are going to ask questions, you know, why do you have two dads or two moms? And so Glendale, they're having big fights right now over stuff like that. And now here you got like stuff like this, where, as a worker, your water break is going to be taken away. We're banning books. We're taking this away. We're taking, in South Dakota, the governor, she took out the lessons here in South Dakota, where it's, if my memory serves me correct, there are reservations out there, and Indians, original Indian people, descendants of Indians, and they want to take all the lessons of about the Indian culture out of those school books in South Dakota, and the governor was able to do that. And so notice how all the, and they're all Republican governors, most of them doing this. And so the more you allow them to get away with this, the worse things get. They are turning, churning, and slowly churning back and peeling layers off and taking us back to the darker times that people fought so hard before us that have been here, that fought so hard to correct and to make life a little better, the quality of it. And here you got these people coming in like Darth Vader and, you know, all of these villains just coming in and just turning back the hands of time. I'm telling you, to not a good time, you know, and it's really sad. I'm very disappointed about this right here. So it's saying they want to take away the 10-minute breaks for construction workers every 4 hours. It also prevents any other local governments from passing similar worker protections. So they want to block that. So no other governors, if they have a conscience and compassion, can block this right here. So just days after Greg Abbott, the governor, ratified the law, officials said that a 35-year-old utility lineman worker to restore power in Marshall, Texas, he died after experiencing symptoms of heat illness and exhaustion. So the heat index, which takes into account both the temperature and the humidity, was 100 degrees Fahrenheit while he was working. So it was an omen that would or could come after this HB 2127 takes effect in September, is when this law is supposed to take effect, wrote the Texas branch AFL-CIO union, referring to the far-reaching law that not only curbs cities' right to enact worker protections, but a number of labor, agriculture, and natural resource and finance measures. Banning required rest breaks for construction workers in Texas heat is deadly. And this is what was said. The law passage has enraged workers, advocates who warn that it will result in even more heat-related deaths and illness in the state that already tallies the highest number of worker deaths due to high temperatures. So in the midst of the record-setting heat wave, I could not think of a worse time for a governor or any elected official who has any kind of compassion. to do this. This is said by David Cruz, the communication director for the League of United Latin American Citizen National. And so there's an abbreviation. It's called LULAC. And so a Latino civil rights group is what it is. This administration is incrementally trying to move us backwards into a dark time in this nation. So when plantation owners and gregarian mentalities prevail. And so basically what they're saying is they're moving us back into those times of slavery days when you had workers working in sweltering heat and they didn't get rest breaks or water breaks, and they had to probably sneak and get water or sneak and go to the bathroom. It's almost like that incident with Amazon where the workers, they could go to the bathroom, but if you went to the bathroom, you could get fired because you're taking too long to use the bathroom. Or it takes a long time to get over there to the bathroom. So your break, your bathroom break, it's over before you even get to the door of the bathroom. So I was hearing things, people urinating in bottles and cups and soda cans, trying to not have to go to the bathroom. And I don't know which location this was, but this was also in, I think this was out here. This might have happened. But it was crazy. It's like all of these people just want to bring us back to a time that is very, very oppressive. And so it's saying 6 out of every 10 construction workers in Texas are Latino. And the labor advocates say that the law will hurt Latino and Black communities that are already disproportionately affected by extreme heat. So Hispanic workers made up a third of all the worker heat deaths since 2010. This is according to NPR and Columbia Studies. So local protections are crucial, advocates say, because the Federal Occupational Safety and Health Administration, OSHA, does not have a national heat protection standard. So still, Republican lawmakers pushing the new law have said it eliminates this hodgepodge or onerous and burdensome regulation that Texas businesses face. So they're more concerned about the money and the businesses and not people's lives and health and safety. So you see the dividing line here just doesn't make sense. And so it's saying that the effort aims to prevent cities and counties from enacting progressive policies that counter the state Republican supermajority aims. So you notice they want to attack anything having to do progressive or with change or with something that they may not be in, you know, agreement totally with right away, or because of the lack of knowledge or education about the situation they know. And so this is where you get all of this. And then this is specifically about just taking away, you know, rights, a need, a basic need for water when you've been working in long periods of heat. So it just doesn't sound right. For too long, progressive municipal officials and agencies have made Texas small business jump through contradicting and confusing hoops. This is said by Republicans, that state representative Dustin Burroughs, who introduced the bill. So after the state's second hottest summer on record last year, Democratic legislatures introduced bills that would have set heat illness guidelines for Texas business and required mandatory breaks for government contractors, but those efforts had failed in advance. Such protections are cruel. But the such protections to have them are crucial, the advocates say, as the climate crisis begins hotter, or it brings hotter weather, more prolonged heat waves in states that are vulnerable, such as Texas, South Texas. In Texas, the number of triple-digit temperatures days have nearly doubled over the past 45 years, a state report has found. So the Union of concerned scientists which are tracking the extreme weather data have flagged that more than half the Americans have faced extreme weather alerts in the past 6 weeks alone. So 11% of the heat alerts during the period of the climate signal linking weather to global heating. And this week, the officials of the National Weather Service have asked Texans to take precautions against heat stroke and heat in the heat wave and heat exhaustion as well. So the record-breaking heat wave is expected to worsen and expand in the coming days, with indexes forecasted to surpass 110 degrees and 43 Celsius, 110 Fahrenheit. So oppressive and persistent heat will become increasingly dangerous, potentially deadly in the south and south central of Texas, especially to people repeatedly and exposed on prolonged periods of duration of time working under those conditions. So many locations in those parts of Texas have already experienced yearly record numbers of hours of dangerous heat indexes readings from the National Weather Service has said. So this is increasing confidence that the dangerous heat wave will continue through the beginning of July 4th holiday week. So they're experiencing heat waves out there. So it is striking, said Cruz of LULAC, that the representative Republican officials want to override local protections that cost businesses just 20 minutes of their workers' productivity to protect against catastrophic illness and death. So we have to take a stand for what is humane, he said. So that's pretty much the article. This article was out of The Guardian, and I'll put it. It basically says the Texas governor has signed a bill to rescind the water breaks as the deadly heat grips the state. And so this is crazy. So I'm thinking, you know, they make small efforts to rescind different things, but those are not small efforts. Those are just adding to all of the things that they've been working on, turning back the hands of time, as I say, to the darker times. And so it starts with the book banning, and it starts with cruelty to workers, taking away workers' rights, not wanting to pay fair wages, you know, things like that. It just doesn't get any better. And the more they're allowed to do this, the worse it gets. Do you see what just happened with Donald Trump? He's not, I don't think he's really going to go to jail. If he does, he's not going to be with the general population. I know this is separate from this situation here, but he's got a lot of cojones, if you want to look at it that way, that he's not afraid. You know, he's doing all these things. I know there's other people that can't even do like one of the things that he did wrong and not go to jail and not go to prison behind it. And so that's how you see where this world is lying, where it's going, how it's looking. It's not looking good. And I mean, if you really look at how things are going, you know why I'm talking like this too, is because I recently, you know, this week I've been back and forth and I've seen Skid Row. It is so depressing. It just seems like they just kind of push people away from certain streets or blocks, and then they find a new corner to live on. I was going to say hang out. They don't even really hang out. They live there at the corner. And so you see people all up and down the streets, tents all up and down the street. People, they're going through whatever it is they go through. They're just out and about, and they're on the street, and it's like, you know, fend for yourself type of situation. And then you see these drug dealers and these gangs that are down there preying upon the vulnerable, who are substance abusers. And you know, it isn't every gang member, so don't get me wrong, I'm not saying everyone's doing it, but there is a group down there that specifically targets and go for the people that are substance abusers. You know, they kind of, that's their customers. It's like really bad. And you have people who they Maybe they just didn't have enough money. They tried to, you know, go through the pandemic and it just didn't work out. The jobs closed or they had to find another job. It took a long while to get on their feet. Just making it, and they ended up getting evicted. They end up in RV or are living out of motels and hotels. There are motels and hotels downtown and in other places that you'll see these people. They're just kind of like, that is where they live, at the hotel and motel, you know. And I feel like, I did mention this on Twitter. I said I felt like, you know, even though they say that this submarine is submersible, the Ocean Gate situation where you had the billionaires, they paid all this money so they could go and take a trip and try to find the sunken Titanic. And I feel like if you have all this money to do these things, look at what's going on in the world. You know, they have all this homelessness and this hunger. People that can't even get on the bus and take a bus ride. People that can't, you know, they're not able to thrive simply because it might be, you know, situations I read where if a person had $300 every month extra, it could help them. If a person had $200, you got these people with billions and millions and billions of dollars, and they're able to do whatever they want, and then they make unwise decisions or unsafe decisions with a whole lot of money that, if they had have done the right thing, they could have helped like multiple people, maybe put some money away for themselves, which they already have money, but they could have helped a lot of people in these communities. They could have given to like maybe some schools or some communities that are, you know, like dilapidated. And it just seems sad. And now you got these governors who, it's an election year, they're trying to fight for a seat or recognition, so they're making all of these inhumane laws, like Mr. Greg Abbott, and like also probably DeSantis in Florida. He's rescinding things and changing, doing things that is somewhat similar. And it just doesn't end. I don't know if you all see what I see, but this does not look good. What they're doing is not humane. It's uncompassionate, it's unfair. And I know some people say, well, the world doesn't operate on fairness. Well, guess what? It should operate on some level of compassion for other human beings. And so if we can just see people suffering, and it's regular families now that are falling into poverty. It's like, I feel like what's going on is you have a select group of people that have a whole lot of money, but they don't want to share any of it. They don't want to help anybody but themselves. And it's wrong. I don't find that to be right. It's wrong. It's wrong if you don't want to try to make life a little bit better for someone else, knowing that you've enjoyed life, you've had everything, and you're, you know, missed. You're able to go to a nice restaurant, or you're able to live good and not have to worry about somebody biting you outside your door. But here you are, you can use your money to go on these elaborate trips and get clothes that you probably don't even wear one time. You just look at it, it looks good. You think you're going to wear it, you don't wear it. You wear it one time and you get rid of it. Here you got people, they are looking for clothes to wear. They're looking for a home to live in. They're looking for food to eat. They don't have a place to sleep. Or if they have a place to sleep, it's not safe. It's got rats. It's got roaches. It's uncomfortable. Are they living around people who are dangerous because they have no other choice because they don't have enough income to live in places that are safer like these rich people do? And so I'm not happy about this. And I know you can hear this in my voice, and I don't sugarcoat what I say. I feel that this thing has gotten far out of control, and somebody needs to stop it. It's going to get worse. It isn't getting any better before it gets worse. I don't see better. I see worse. I feel like they're using politics to make lives of people that don't have a lot of money more complicated. They're attacking progression. You mean change? things that make people's lives better, but you don't want to see that. So something is clearly wrong with this government in the U.S. when they have these type of people come in and they, at the stroke of a pen, can change laws. They attack the abortion, women's rights. I mean, it just doesn't end. They had to start there. They Roe versus Wade to overturn it. That's a victory for the Republicans. They love doing that. So next thing you know, what else will they do? I hear that some places they're going to start making kids work. You don't see what's happening? Somebody needs to see it. I see it. I know a few other people see what's going on. This is not good. None of this is good. And you know, Elon Musk, I know you might hear this, you might even see this, and maybe you won't. If you do hear it, what you guys are doing is not helping the communities. It's not helping the world. It is making lives of people who don't have a voice. It makes them more stressed, more fearful, and more underfoot and toe, where they don't know where their next meal is going to be. Anytime you make people work under conditions where they could die, then where are we headed? It isn't good, I can tell you that. He made it where people can't even live in a place. Living in a place is a luxury now. You rent it, people are burdened with it. You're paying rent to places that in the 80s, these places were like what? Like 500 a month, 600. Now you're looking at like 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 a month for places that there's not much change. They look like they did when I was growing up. They look similar to what they put a couple of fixtures in, and they get the cheapest stuff to put in these apartments. And they patchwork. They patch it up until it breaks down again, and they come back and put some cheap shit in there. And so you know that's what's happening. It's unfair. It's inhumane. It's not beyond unfair. It's just not right. And so something needs to be done about it. You know what? All these people I'm not voting for. I'm definitely not. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm not scared to say it. I'm not voting for any of these people because I see what they're doing is attacking people's livelihoods. And this is wrong. And then you got those people down there in Glendale fighting. You're fighting people and you're going to end up getting arrested. You're fighting people because you don't understand who they are. And if you don't understand them, then why don't you learn about them? That's what they're trying to do, is teach. It doesn't say that you have to agree with everything. It's saying that you're teaching, you're arming your kids with education so that when they grow up, they're not shocked in reality to see, oh, this is what they've been hiding from me. Because they're going to see it. It's out there everywhere. And so we got the internet. We didn't have that when we were kids. Everything that you're hiding, you're gonna find it, whether you like it or not. So you're not really doing anything. All you're doing is trying to get elected. And you don't care about anybody. All you care about is your money, your wealth, and getting elected, and having all this media attention, and how horrible you are, and how great you are to other horrible people who think that what you're doing, which is inhumane, is right, and it isn't. It's not right at all. None of it is.